Hooray for Thursday night streaming! Hey! I finished all the uniforms. Went a bit over the top with, yeah, I just went a bit over the top, but. Eh, it looks good. Anyway. So, while we're travelling, I can talk a little bit. I'm really minding my mind of what I'm going to do yet, because more than likely some of these crew members will change eventually. Like, you see that some of these are in purple? You want the purple ones. I don't give you much, I think it's just like a better trait slot, or we get better traits altogether. I mean, that's about it. Like, he's a good, he's plasma gun specialist. Plasma weapon specialist. As long as I give him plasma weapons, he's actually really good. For the ground combat, anyway. Power recharge speed for the cloaking is good. Apparently stubborn. These get better, like, these are very basic. Like, being creative is kind of nice, but that's a kit performance, and I think that only affects that. Her, honestly. I'm not sure, actually. That's nice to have forever though. Plus 2.5 to defense rate. And then getting better stealth for it as well. Damn as well. I haven't really adjusted these yet. Bonus energy damage, which is kind of nice. And active sensors. Might leave that on. We'll see. Covert as well. And I get kit performance as well, which is nice. Oh, field technician, sorry. And then there's my skill tree, which, yeah. Eventually goes into specialization ones, which I already know which two I want. Right here. And that looks like the Janus Dyson Sphere over there. I'm really curious. I'm pretty sure that's the Janus Dyson Sphere. Yeah, it might be actually. I really can't go too fast here yet. Like, my warp is warp 5 at best. Oh, I've just seen what system it is. Never mind. I'm gonna turn around. That's for something much later. That one.
Show me your teeth, little prey.
We have nothing to hide. We're simply trying to survive.
Here isn't easy.
Thank you.
cold out here today, isn't it?
We have them trapped in the warehouse.
Excellent. Activate the transport inhibitors to stop them from beaming out.
Very well. Do you have any further orders?
Just stay out of our way while we subdue the prey.
Thank you.
You cannot understand the choices we must make.
There's still hope for you, Tovon. For us.
Charva. You can't trust her. I know her too well for that. We grew up together. I was her friend. But that's all over. It ended the day she joined the Tal Shiar.
You are being deceived.
There's a lot I have to say about Charva. As you may have guessed, we used to be quite close. There's a lot of history between us, but all that's really important is that we went separate ways. She thought that the Tal Shiar could ensure security for our people, and I didn't. It's just bringing up a lot of old feelings. As I mentioned, we have a turbulent past. We grew up together. Once, thought we might have a future together. Those were in the dark years after the destruction of the homeworld. We survived, but it tore us apart. I just wanted to make a new start. She was convinced that nowhere was safe. She kept talking about working with the military or the Tal Shiar. I argued that the only way we'd be safe was to be able to stand up for ourselves. There's a lot I have to say about Charva. I don't believe Detan is a terrorist. I think he's an idealist who's trying to come to terms with the chaos. Detan would never knowingly sanction violence, especially against innocents. He doesn't even like us fighting the Tal Shiar, although he sees the need. But Detan isn't the only person making decisions in the Republic. Maybe there are some people who see the Republic as their chance to have a little revenge. I don't know. I think Charva is wrong about Detan and the Republic. But that doesn't mean it's outside the bounds of possibility that someone has taken things too far, or has a secret program that Detan doesn't know about. If she knows something that we don't, we should try to find out what it is. There's a lot I have to say. Well, Charva's not a bad person. At least she wasn't. But she is misguided. She's turned a blind eye to the excesses of the Tal Shiar, and she probably doesn't even know about most of them. The Tal Shiar are masters of propaganda, after all. I think that anything she tells us is going to be something that the Tal Shiar wants us to hear. We should gather our own evidence and draw our own conclusions. There's a lot I have...
Congratulations, Suntory.
It looks like we're not the only ones visiting. All this debris has attracted Nausicaan scavengers. Recommend that we clear the area of these pirates while searching for any traces of weapon signatures in the wreckage. I don't want any pirates disturbing the remains of the ships where our friends died.
Let's go.
We didn't find anything unusual on these ships, and I knew we wouldn't. I want to believe her, but she's not the person I knew. She's Tall Shiar. Still, I am picking up some strange energy readings from the surface of the planet. Perhaps we should continue our search there. This was such a peaceful place once, and so beautiful.
for what they have done to our colony.
I remember that painting. We should take it with us as a reminder of home. DeVex's old helmet reminds me of better times. Enemy ship on sensors.
Our eyes and ears are everywhere.
Warning, ship is under attack.
I can tell you the truth.
Congratulations, Centurion.
We're counting on you.
We've arrived at the source of the distress signal. Scanning the area now. The ship is badly damaged, but there's no clear relationship between the distortion and the ship. I ran a comparison to the anomalies we scanned previously in the Kittimer system. While they appear similar at first look, the spike in Tetrions is different from what we've seen before. Sir, there's no sign of a Republic vessel in the area. Whatever happened here is unfortunate, but I recommend we continue our search elsewhere. It may look suspicious if we linger. Cardassians use a recursive encryption algorithm to protect their data from unauthorized access. We'd have to be on their bridge to tap into their systems. We have no idea what happened to this ship. We could be putting ourselves at risk for the sake of curiosity. I recommend we leave and continue our search elsewhere. It's your call, but if you're going over to that ship, then I'm coming with you. Interesting. No visible damage. Why would they abandon the ship? The bridge appears operational, but where's the crew? No other life signs detected. We're alone. Here's something odd. There are no corpses on this ship. The ship description fits what we've seen of the Alachi. Several security logs were accessed recently. I think you're going to want to see this. The security recording is from 3 days ago. Whatever it is, it explains why there aren't any corpses. One more. Pulling it up now. Wait. That noise. Several ships are on approach and requesting status. Sir, they're Cardassian.
Collateral damage is acceptable.
Two more waves are approaching the system. Recommend a defensive posture with power to shields. The Cardassians were unaware of what had happened to their missing vessel. It appears the Alachi attacked them while they were hunting for our ships. Bad luck. We should destroy the derelict. Let the True Way think that the Republic defeated all of their patrols. According to new intel, Sela has started paying privateers to capture or destroy Romulan Republic ships. That would explain why these Cardassians are operating outside their normal territory. I suggest we track these True Way ships back to their base. If we're lucky, they'll lead us right to the missing Republic ships. Recommend we stay cloaked as we approach the station, sir. If we avoid the magnetic flux energy, we should be able to remain cloaked as we approach the station.
Pay for your interference.
Thank you. alone.
Congratulations, Centurion.
While searching for signs of weaponized protomatter, one of our long-distance research probes made a...
Ignore that. It's a long way away yet. Thanks for watching. Till next time.